So, Assassin's Creed is kind of a convoluted mess, but it's a mix of very bad and very good. So while it's very murky, I want to make sure that my review is crystal clear on 2 points. The first is that overall, it's not a good movie, all right? And I really, really strongly would not recommend anybody watch this, at least in theaters, unless they like the game, they're a cinephile who's curious to see what exactly went wrong, you know, if you want to do a little autopsy on Assassin's Creed, or if you're a Michael Fassbender fan. And that leads me into the second thing I want to make very clear, and that's that I really appreciate and respect the effort that Michael Fassbender clearly has put into this movie, both as an actor and as a producer, even if he was only successful in one of those tasks. Yes, his performance here is the one he succeeded in, surprise, surprise, one he's been doing for a while, one he's just starting doing, producing, but his acting here is amazing. Particularly in like the, when he's being executed at the beginning of the movie. I love it that he wasn't like, yeah, whatever, execute me, you know, like, I don't care, I'm so cool. He was like genuinely terrified, and it really, you know, it helped me to connect to the character. It was one of the few moments that, it was at the beginning of the movie and I had no idea what was coming, but I was really impressed. And I think that throughout the movie, he did a great job from the dramatic sequences, like the quiet moments, to the action scenes. He's very good at action at this point. And also he had incredible chemistry with his two female leads, Marion Cotillard and Ariane Lebed, a new actress. She's a Greek-French actress. She was very good. She was very good with her action sequences as well. Both actresses were quite good. But, you know, I have to say, it was an oddly sexy movie. I think partly because it was so sensual and so emotional and so physical, but there was, like, really no story. I was like, look, Marion Cotillard, although I feel bad, she's getting accused of having affairs with everyone. She's like, I can't help it if I have amazing chemistry with all the guys that I act with. But I'd be like, Marion Cotillard and Michael Fassbender, if you guys wanted to spend time together, even if it was just, like, platonic or like bittersweet romantic, don't make me and Ubisoft pay for it, right? Find another excuse. But I will say that as a producer, Michael Fassbender is very well intentioned. He just didn't do a good job. And I think that he also must have called in a lot of favors for this movie. Like the cast, you're like, what? I mean, clearly he was like, oh, I'm making this movie. I'm trying to be a producer. I'm taking it really seriously. Will you be in it? And I think it's to Michael Fassbender's credit that he asked. And I think it's also to his credit that people said, yes, I will be in Assassin's Creed, which is crazy. But the movie overall, unfortunately, reeks of first-time-itis. And maybe Michael Fassbender wouldn't have agreed to be in the film if he couldn't produce it. Maybe that was part of the real value to him in taking on another franchise, right? He's already Magneto. But I think that Ubisoft, unfortunately, is also new. And this is like a big franchise for them. So I'm like, you shouldn't let Michael Fassbender practice on your franchise. But so Fassbender's new, Ubisoft is new, and then also the director is new to action movies. So it's too much newness. They should have had an experienced action, you know, mainstream blockbuster producer who knows, for instance, that in an action movie, you have to either open with an action sequence or at least some kind of story hook. You don't wait 20 minutes or so. It's like action movie making 101. But to be fair, though, if they were to make another one of these, and they clearly want to, and I mean, of course they want to, it's a franchise in the video game world, Ubisoft obviously wants it to be one in the movie world, but if they brought in some experienced people behind the camera to help out, I'd give it another try, because I liked enough of what I saw here. But on that note, the movie has a fatal flaw that we see so often these days, and that I think it's gunning too hard for that awesome sequel. They're like, oh, you know, you think it's good now, wait until the next movie. And it's like, focus on the movie that you're making, and then hope that you get to make a sequel, right? I mean, it's not so bad to leave like a couple of hanging questions or lingering questions for a potential sequel, but when it's clear that you're building up for that amazing movie sometime in the future, it's a little frustrating because I'm paying to see a movie right now. I would also describe the movie, again, as a dream because of those high emotions, thanks to Fassbender and Cotillard in particular. And also, like, the visuals. The visuals were very pretty with the bleeding effect and all that and going back in time and the way the camera moved. But just the storyline was so ridiculously convoluted, those visuals, I think, ended up not being engaging enough. And I think that going forward, when it comes to video game movies, when I tweeted my first response to this after I got out of the theater, a lot of you were like, ah, it's the video game movie curse. They just can't be adapted. And I was thinking about it, and I knew that going into, so I was thinking about it while I was watching the movie, and I was like, you know, I wonder if Michael Fassbender actually sat down and talked to anyone who plays Assassin's Creed, you know, like did a survey. And I think that would be something that would behoove all filmmakers who try to adapt video games to find out what keeps people coming back to these brands. Like, what's the appeal? Because I can't understand the appeal based on the film adaptations alone. I think they're missing something. Or maybe I'd be curious to see how people who play the game feel. Did you legitimately feel this was, because a couple of you said you liked it. Is this like a legitimately good Assassin's Creed, not only an Assassin's Creed movie, but a legitimately good movie if you know all the extra stuff from playing the game? Or do you just like it because it's fun to see something you love in a different medium, which I've totally experienced myself. I think the DCEU and sometimes other comic book movies get a lot of mileage out of that. I feel bad commenting on it, but I think it's something people are paying a lot of attention to these days, and I feel it would be irresponsible of me not to at least touch on the fact that it was a little weird at points seeing Michael Fassbender in light brown face playing a Spaniard, because he's so clearly an Irishman, right? He's not one of those actors that has range. And I was like, oh, I'm glad that Diego Luna, for instance, and I know Diego Luna's from Mexico and this is supposed to be Spain, but we're getting closer, right? I'm not an extremist. I'm fine with a little bit of leeway. But, you know, when you actually, you know, tan your actor so that he can play a character, I think that should be a sign that, you know, maybe this isn't a good casting choice. But anyway, with Diego Luna in Rogue One, I'm like, oh, well, maybe that's finally a high enough caliber role for a Latino actor that they would be considered maybe for, if they were to make an Assassin's Creed type movie in the future, Diego Luna would get the appropriate call. But Michael Fassbender was very good. And that I also say to his credit as a producer that for the other period roles, they did cast actors from, you know, the basic appropriate region, and they worked very hard to be authentic to the setting and the culture. However, this movie took place during the Spanish Inquisition, or at least I'd say 40% of it did. And I didn't learn anything about the Spanish Inquisition. But even worse, I don't think I was supposed to learn anything about the Spanish Inquisition. And while I'm not expecting an in-depth history lesson, I would have liked to have picked up a few things, especially because Hollywood has done so little to cover the Spanish Inquisition. I think that Hollywood should never underestimate how a little bit of history can go quite a long way in making me feel that I at least got something for my time and money. So to everyone who made this movie, I say, nice try. Love the effort, but you really should have realized, and I think it would have been evident in the scripting stage, that you need help. You needed help from people who had experience, because good action movies aren't as easy to make as it apparently looks. So that's my review of Assassin's Creed, and I guess to some degree of Michael Fassbender as a producer. I'd be very curious to hear your thoughts on it if you've seen the movie, and also video game movies in general. What do you think can break the curse? We have more coming. They're still working on Uncharted. They have Tomb Raider. So we'll see what can be done. But so far, it's interesting because they've been able to adapt comics. I guess because on a final note, I think there's so much interactiveness to video games where you're a lot of times dictating the action because you're actually playing the game. It's a different experience than like a comic is still a narrative. You know, it's still a narrative form of storytelling. So maybe that's what's really keeping them from being able to do the adaptations correctly. The mediums, they might both be visual mediums, but the storytelling and the point of them is so different that it's maybe further apart than Hollywood and the video game industry realizes. All right, so write your thoughts down below, and you can check out some more videos right now.